In this video, we're going to be talking about layers, clipping masks, and regular masks inside of Rebelle 6. So we have here an image. This image is by Zach Leonardi, and I've used the lasso tool right over here, magic wand, to remove the background on this image. So we're going to play with creating a mask first. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a layer mask by right-clicking right over the top, add layer mask, and now I'm going to select a watercolor brush and we're going to paint right over the top. Now we can't see anything because I have white selected. If we choose black, what it's going to do is the darker the color is, the more it's going to erase or mask. So the black is hiding the mask, the white is revealing. So we can non-destructively erase certain parts of our image and show them again. This is really nice. It reminds me of the liquify tool where you can restore the image back to how it was. Now, if you choose something kind of in the middle of the very bright or very dark, it's going to do a mask with some opacity. Again, black fully removes, white fully restores. Now that mask you can turn on or off, and you'll notice that the mask is surrounded this rectangle with a blue outline. If we select the layer itself and not the mask, we can continue painting directly on that layer. If we select the mask, we're going to be masking or removing the mask, and that's it. Let's look at clipping masks. Now I have an image I pulled in from online. This is a starry sky, and I'm going to right click on it directly over the image itself, and we're going to choose clipping mask. Now you can see that this has layered directly over the top of just the pixels that have opacity. So anything that has any amount of opacity in it is being used as a clipping mask. Now we have an option for lock transparency, so let's look at the differences between those two. So we're going to hide this, we're going to choose lock transparency. The difference between lock transparency and using a clipping mask is lock transparency is going to be directly on this layer, so this is a permanent action, so it's a destructive action. Using a mask, you can adjust different properties. You can change the way that it blends, and all of this is non-destructive. So you can see how powerful this can be when you're working with multiple layers and trying to get just that right type of look. Let's say we make some changes using the mask, and we want to apply those changes. We can right-click directly on the layer and choose Apply Layer Mask. This is essentially a merged down feature, so it's going to combine the layer masks, masking directly onto the image. So now we cannot restore this. This is a permanent change. Now, if we have multiple layers in Rebelle 6, let's go ahead and add a couple layers here. You'll notice that the clipping mask immediately stopped working when we added these other layers because it's only affecting the layer directly below it. However, if you want it to affect more than one layer, create a group. Now, if you're using masking fluid layers or tracing layers, if you have these turned on, it will only affect items inside of a group. So we have a group here. If we select here and turn on mask opaque, it'll affect everything inside of this group, but it will not affect anything outside of the group. The little white dot for influence layers that was there for Rebelle 5 is no longer there in Rebelle 6. The same is true of tracing layers, masking fluid layers, and tracing layers both behave the same way. You can constrain what those do to a group by creating a group and then making sure that you're using a masking fluid layer or tracing layer inside of that group. For more information on masking fluid layers or tracing layers, please check out our video specifically on that topic. We'll put the link to that in the description of this video. If you have any questions about clipping masks or layer masks, ask them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.